It's time. We've really enjoyed the couch being here, but I'm ready to go back to the theater seats, especially with football season being here and getting that cooler weather. I want those heated seats back and the recliner. I think I'm ready. And the cup holders. I've missed those cup holders so much. Let's go get those theater seats in.
You ready?
I'm ready. Are you ready?
You wanna do my shimmy?
I can't do it as well as you.
Hey, where are we going?
Where are we going?
Well, we're going to Florida.
Going to Florida.
But tonight?
We're going to Harvest Host.
Imagine that. And what kind of Harvest Host are we going to?
I mean, we really branch out a lot with Harvest Host. A brewery.
And that brewery is called
Goat Island
Brewing,
I think? In Coleman, Alabama. I think it's Goat Island.
All right, do your shimmy. Where are we going tonight?
Alabama.
Oh, come on, a little more enthusiasm.
Alabama.
Woo!
The right. Alabama shakes.
All right.
We are heading out for a week-ish. I actually have 2 weeks off work. I feel very spoiled because we just had like an 8-day stretch off. We have 2 weeks off work. I'm very excited about. And so we kind of last minute-ish decided to go to Florida. We found a spot on the beach for pretty cheap, and we'll tell you guys more about that soon. We're gonna meet up with a couple of our friends in Florida, which is awesome. Every October we usually do a trip with a group of people, and we haven't really been able to. We didn't think we were gonna see any of them this year, and we get to see two of them at least in Florida. But tonight, we're stopping at a brewery in Alabama. It's a Harvest Host. You guys know how much we love it. Excited, ready to hit the road. It's gonna be a long drive day. Khali's coming with us, which is very exciting.
Yeah, she's coming this week.
She didn't get to go on our last trip. She's been a shadow the entire morning, and she's been in the truck for like the last half an hour. I think she's afraid we're gonna leave her.
She's ready to go.
You ready to go?
Yeah. You're up in the Hogwarts.
I know. I was wearing my Harry Potter mask too this morning.
All right.
Nerd alert.
Let's go.
Accio adventure. You're good.
So I just wanted to mention real quick a couple new products that we're trying. This is a water fresh. It goes in your fresh water. This is from Valterra. You can probably buy this on Amazon. I'll try to add this to our Amazon store as well. But this goes right in your fresh tank. It makes your water taste a little bit better if it's kind of stale or stagnant or anything like that. We used it a while back and I noticed a huge difference in our drinking water. Now we have the water filtration system, which we're gonna update you later on in the week and let you know how it's gone, but I just wanted to mention that. And this is Happy Campers. This is for your black tank, and I've actually been using this for a little while now, and I've noticed that there is really no stink in the black tank anymore. Some of the other products kind of cover up that smell, but I've been really happy with this. It is a little bit more expensive. I'll make sure this is added to our Amazon store link down below, but I just want to show these to you guys. We'll be using both of these this week, and yeah, just wanted to mention these two products that we are using now. We stopped for a break. We're about, 6 hours from Alabama.
We've only been driving like an hour and a half.
We've only been driving an hour, but sometimes you just gotta stop where you can, so we did that real quick.
Another reason we love Flying J's, not only do they have the dedicated aisles just to RVs and trailers and vans and such, but There's also air hoses. Dump station. Non-potable water, but still water. Dump station. It's a timed thing, 10 bucks. Pretty cool. Callie's been living that farm dog life. She doesn't know what a leash is anymore.
I guess I should. There was another dog in there.
Yeah, they're dog friendly. I just said I didn't know if they're dog friendly inside as well. We'll take her.
Okay. There was a dog in there.
It specifically says they're dog friendly and they have an AstroTurf beer garden, but don't let your dogs do their business on it, please.
Okay.
Ready? Chilly.
It is chilly this morning. Another successful harvest host last night. We stayed at Goat Island Brewing in Coleman, Alabama. Did I get that right?
Yeah.
Wow.
We may have reviewed it before we turned the camera on.
I never know where we're at. So, what'd you think?
I really liked it. The brewery itself is really nice inside. Dogs are allowed inside, which is always a huge plus for us.
Yeah, that was really nice.
Unfortunately, it's Saturday night and they had a band, which is, they're actually a really good band.
Not unfortunate.
Not unfortunate.
Unfortunate for Callie.
For our weird dog. She doesn't like loud noises and like new spaces a lot of times. So she got to go in for a little bit, got a lot of lovin's, and then we put her back out in the camper and she took a nap.
The band was actually really good.
It was actually really good, yeah.
The beers were good. The
staff was super friendly. And redheads, nice. Too, so.
There was a high school reunion going on.
Yeah, something.
So it was pretty packed. But all in all, great harvest. So this is perfect right off the interstate. We're going to hop right back on the interstate and get down to Destin here in just a little bit.
That's where we're going. I don't know if we've said it, but we're going to Florida.
Yes, our friends are already there. Our friends Steve and Jana drove down from Kansas City, so we're meeting them there this afternoon. Mm-hmm. Check-in's not till 3, but we got about five and a half hours to get down there, so we need to get on the road. It's about 9.
Yeah.
Anything else?
I'm excited. Excited to show you guys where we're staying. We've never actually had the camper on a beach, and we're going to be on the beach, not like right on the water, but on the beach.
Yeah.
And we've really lucked out with this spot, and we're going to tell you how we found it. I'm excited.
I will say one thing real quick about the harvest host. We did have to park right next to a dumpster,
yeah.
Which wasn't their fault by any means, but yeah, little smelly last night. Little smelly.
It was a little too chilly to be outside anyway, so that was fine.
That's true.
But so. It is nice level parking. It's concrete. There was a couple other campers. One's pulling out right now, it sounds like.
Yeah.
So we felt really safe. That's kind of a thing with boondocking sometimes. I felt really safe here.
Yeah.
Totally fine.
Yeah, and if you get here early enough, on the far side of the parking lot right behind me, there's a tree line. So these people that are pulling out right now got that spot. So if you got here early enough, you could park right next to the trees and have kind of a backyard almost. Mm-hmm. It's kind of scenic. So yeah, right here next to the brewery. So all right, you
ready
good?
To hit the road?
I'm ready to hit the road.
Let's do this.
All right, let's go.
Every time, you guys. Every time. I'm not even running. I should start keeping like his phone or something. Or keep the directions so he doesn't know where he's going. Boy! You, sir.
Man, the things you do to get good B-roll. Are you gonna help me?
Nope.
So close.
I don't know what your signal means.
I thought we went through this. So I pick up the phone, dial your number on the tone to set things straight.